You're listening to Duck Commander Devotions for Kids, published by Tommy Nelson, written by Korie Robertson and Chrys Howard, and read by Gabe Wicks.
For the parents, welcome to Duck Commander Devotions for Kids. We are so excited about this book and honored that you have chosen it as a resource for your children. For a few years now, our family has been in the public eye with our TV show, Duck Dynasty. If you're a weekly viewer, thank you for supporting us. Our prayer is that the TV show honors God and gives families an opportunity to share their lives as they watch the show together. We also hope the show opens the door for deeper discussions about faith and family. We are a mother-daughter team. It's been such fun as we wrote each devotion to recall events that our children, siblings, and parents have gone through. We've tried to make God's words come to life through the use of family stories. These stories are not from the reality show, but from real life. We know that your family has learned many of the same lessons. Of course, your stories might sound a little different from ours. That is, unless you live on a swamp in Louisiana and make duck calls. We hope you enjoy sharing the contents of this book with your children. We love reading to and with our children and know that storytelling is one of the best ways to get a message across to kids. As you read, remember to add your own story. Your kids will love it if you do. Happy reading and studying. Hugs and blessings, Korie and Chrys. For the children. Welcome to Duck Commander Devotions for Kids. We are so happy that you're going to spend some time getting to know God better through this book. We love to read, but we know that reading isn't for everyone, so we worked hard to make these messages short, fun, and meaningful. As you listen to each story, think about your life and the lessons you have already learned. Who knows? One day you might write a book. We know that God has big plans for your life. Our advice is to keep your eyes open to see and your ears ready to hear. That way, when God has something important for you to see and hear, you're ready. May God bless you in all you do. Hugs and blessings, Korie and Chrys. Words to waterproof. Pleasant words are like a honeycomb. They make a person happy and healthy. Proverbs 16:24. Poor little Bella was a pacifier addict. Perhaps you were too. A lot of babies love their pacifiers, and when it's time to give it up, they don't want to. But when Korie decided to take her pacifier away, Bella discovered a good thing. Without the pacifier in her mouth, she could talk. Soon, she was asking for cookies and juice and telling her older brother, Will, no. Now, Bella had a voice and a choice about how to use it. A voice means you have words to use, which means you also have words to choose. Did you know that your words are super powerful? You have the power to change someone's day just by the words you choose to use. It's true. You can say, I'm so glad you're my friend. And that person will go through the day feeling happy and encouraged. But if you say something like, you're no fun, I don't want to play with you, that person will feel sad, all because of what you said. Making the choice to use kind words says a lot about who you are. When you let your words hurt someone, you're making a bad choice. When you use your words to build someone up, that's using your voice to make God happy. Dear God, I want to bless other people, not hurt them. Please help me use my words to help others. In Jesus' name, amen. Duck Commander in Action. Use your words wisely. Refuse to say words that are angry, mean, or hurtful to others. Today is a good day to speak kindly to the kids in your class and in your neighborhood. Think about it like this. There are special sprays that will waterproof your boots so rain will roll right off them. Using kind words helps to waterproof the people you love, causing other unkind words to roll right off them. You will be like a kindness umbrella, covering your friends and brothers and sisters with love. Work and be happy. Hard work always pays off. Mere talk puts no bread on the table. Proverbs 14:23. Willie loves working outside and loves working with kids. So for 10 years, he worked at a Christian camp. One thing he learned was that even when you're doing what you love, you still have to work hard. One day, the toilets in the girls' village stopped up, and there was no one else to fix them. So Willie did the hard thing and the yucky thing. He fixed the potties and cleaned up the mess so all the campers would have a nice bathroom when they came back to camp. Do you know that God designed us to work? Even in the Garden of Eden, God told Adam and Eve to work the garden. Work is a hard thing, We have to use our muscles and our brains to do things like clean a bathroom or sweep the porch or do homework. But it's also the thing that makes us happier people. That doesn't mean you'll go around smiling the entire time you're sweeping the porch. No, think about it this way. Think of a time when you worked hard at something. Maybe it was a sport you love, like football, or maybe it was a homework assignment, and you really gave it your all. You might have been tired when you finished, but you were proud of what you did. It's the way God designed us. Working hard gives us a good feeling about ourselves. God, some days I don't help as much as I should. Please help me to help others so they will see you in me. In His name, amen. Duck Commander in action. Helping your mom clean the kitchen or working with your dad in the yard or doing your homework are all examples of work. Take a few pieces of paper and write down different jobs you could do. Then take those papers to your mom or dad and ask them to pick one job for you to do. Your mom or dad will be very surprised and happy, happy, happy when you show them how hard you can work. Speaking softly says a lot. A gentle answer will calm a person's anger, but an unkind word will cause more anger. Proverbs 15:1. With four boys in the house, Miss K was constantly separating her rowdy boys. Each boy felt like it was his job to end an argument. One day, two of the boys were fighting over the oven. Isn't that crazy? At the same time, Willie wanted to make a pizza and Jace wanted to make toast. Their friend was watching the argument and simply said, "You're not being very good examples for God." Both boys stopped what they were doing and ended the fight. Remember this, yelling louder usually won't end an argument. It just makes the room louder and your mom crazy. But when you are calm and quietly say what you need to say, things usually get better. The Bible calls this a gentle answer. Willie and Jace's friend showed them that a gentle answer really does work. Think about a teacher you might have who talks more softly the louder the kids get. She will get the room to be quieter by being quiet herself. That's a smart teacher. There's a funny saying that goes, even a fish wouldn't get into trouble if he kept his mouth shut. Dear God, thank you for my family. I know I need to be more patient sometimes. Help me to speak kindly and lovingly to my brothers and sisters. In Jesus' name, amen. Duck Commander in action. All brothers and sisters argue sometimes, but it's important to remember that our families are the people who will love us for our whole lives. If you see yourself ready to argue with your brother or sister, stop and count to 10. After you've gotten to 10, if you're still angry, start counting again. Counting takes your attention away from the problem, and you'll learn to think before you speak. God's love is an open door. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. 1 John 4:8. Missy and her children are the singers in the Robertson family. Uncle Cy wins the prize for being the loudest singer. He could wake a hibernating bear from his winter-long sleep. One of our favorite songs is simply called Love One Another. It's a great song because it talks about love being from God. Love is a word that can mean many things. Sometimes we say we love ice cream, or we love a pet, or we love our parents. Each of those types of love is different. We really don't love our parents in the same way we love ice cream, do we? God has blessed us with so many things to love. And because we are human, we might love something one day and something else another day. But God's love for us will never change. The Bible tells us His love endures forever. How long is forever? Well, it's like saying the word on over and over and never stopping. Like this. On and on and on and on and on and on and on. You get it? Forever doesn't have an ending. It keeps on going. It's great to know that God's love for us will keep on going too. Dear God, thank you for loving me so much that you sent your only son to die for me. Thank you for always being there for me. In Jesus' name, amen. Duck Commander in action. Frozen was a very popular movie in 2014. Everyone was singing the songs, and they were great songs. One of the Robertson favorites was Love is an Open Door. The song says that life can be so much more with love, but life can be even more with God's love. Here's a fun activity for you to do. Draw a heart on a piece of paper. Next, decorate the heart with the things you love. You can either write them with a marker or cut them out of a magazine and glue them on. Then share what you made with your family. Thank you. Praise the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love endures forever. Psalm 106, 1. When Phil and Miss Kay were first married, they didn't have much money for food, but God always provided for them with fresh fish and deer meat. Phil didn't know God and didn't understand that God was taking care of them. He wasn't thankful for the food they had to eat. One day, a special friend told Phil about God, and Phil began to read his Bible. He learned that God loves and takes care of His people. That was many years ago. Now, Phil always prays before every meal, showing his children and grandchildren that he knows that God has provided for them. Sometimes we forget to thank God for all the blessings in our lives. When you do something nice for someone, it's good to hear them say, "Thank you." God also loves to hear us say, "Thank you." How do we tell God we're thankful? We can thank Him by praying to Him, or singing a song, or reading His words in the Bible. These are all great ways to tell God that you love Him, and you know He's taking care of you. Father in heaven, thank you for everything. I know that all good things come from you, so thank you for all that you have given me. In His name, amen. Duck Commander in action. It only takes a few seconds to be thankful. It's only two simple words, thank and you, but they mean so much. Today is a great day to thank God for the things He has blessed you with. Take out a piece of paper and write down some of those things. You might be thankful for yummy food to eat or for a family that loves you. Then put that list on your refrigerator or on the bathroom mirror in your room. That way you'll be reminded every day to thank God. The Good Book. Follow God's example, therefore, as dearly loved children. Ephesians 5:1. Miss Kay loves to cook. In fact, she has her own cookbook called Miss Kay's Duck Commander Kitchen. When she decides to make a cake, she has to follow the instructions carefully so that she can make the cake exactly right. If you've ever tried to make a cake, you had to do the same thing, or else it might have exploded in the oven. Cookbooks are good to have because someone has already tested the recipes and written them down for us to follow. Did you know that God gave us an instruction book too? It's called the Bible. The Bible is our guide to getting to heaven, and it gives us instructions on how to live a good life while on earth. If we will read our Bibles every day, we'll learn more about God and His plan for our lives. The Bible has instructions for how to treat your brothers and sisters, how to be a good son or daughter, and how to treat your neighbors. If you like to cook, then a cookbook is very important. If you want to live for God, the most important book is His book, the Bible. Lord, I want to know more about You. Thank You for the Bible so I can learn Your will for me. Give me ears to hear and eyes to see. In Jesus' name, amen. Duck Commander in action. First, read this verse from James 1, 19 and 20. My dear brothers and sisters, take note of this. Everyone should be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry, because human anger does not produce the righteousness that God desires. Next, circle the words in this verse that tell you a way to act. Yeah, you should have circled quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to become angry. These are all important lessons. Just think about all the great ways you'll learn to live a better life when you read your Bible. Talk about Jesus. I praise Your greatness, my God the King. I will praise You forever and ever. Psalm 145, 1. One time, Willie went on a mission trip to another country. In this country, the people spoke Spanish. Willie couldn't speak Spanish, so someone had to translate what he said to the people. He was there to tell them how much God loves them and how to live for God and to make Him number one in their lives. But one day, the interpreter got confused. Instead of saying Willie's words in Spanish, he just repeated them in English. Soon, everyone was laughing because no one could understand the interpreter or Willie. Even though no one could understand him, Willie was saying great things about God. He was praising God by talking about Him, and he was doing what the Bible commands, to tell others about Jesus. When we talk about God to other people, it shows God that He's important to us. It's kind of like when you like a certain movie and want others to see it. You tell your friends and family all about it. Some people may not want to hear about it, but you tell them anyway. They might change their minds and go see the movie. The same can be true of your words about God. Some people may not want to hear, but if you tell them about how much He loves them and wants to be their friend, they might start to listen and ask questions, and you'll be there to answer them. Dear Father, I want to share my love for you with others. Help me to use my words to lead others to you. In his name, amen. Duck Commander in action. Someone really close to you may have never heard about Jesus. You don't have to sound like a grown-up to tell a friend about Jesus. You don't even have to go to a foreign country like Willie did. You just have to be willing to say how much you love God and what a good friend he is. One good way to share about God's love is to make a bookmark for your friends. You can just cut out strips out of paper and write your favorite verse on them. Maybe you'll even add some of your own artwork. Then pass out the bookmarks to your friends. Every time they use them, they'll be reminded that God loves them. The Bible, our powerful sword. God's word is alive and working. It is sharper than a sword sharpened on both sides. Hebrews 4:12. What is your favorite drink? Have you ever had iced tea? In the South, people drink iced tea to keep cool on hot summer days. But Uncle Si drinks iced tea all day, every day, even in the winter. He has a special cup his mother sent him when he was a soldier fighting a war in another country. That cup reminded him of his family back home, so he kept it close. If you see Uncle Si today, you'll see that same iced tea cup in his hand. Do you have something special like a stuffed animal or a blanket that you like to keep close? Blankets and stuffed animals can also remind us of our family and help us feel safe. Uncle Si keeps something else close to him, his Bible. He loves iced tea and his teacup, but he loves his Bible even more. He knows that the Bible has God's words written in it, and those words are as powerful as a very sharp sword. Imagine if you were in battle, but you forgot your sword. Wow, that would make the battle very hard to win. And it's the same way with the Bible. If you don't keep it close, you won't have it as you fight the battles of life. God's word is our weapon against Satan. When we have the words of the Bible in our heart, Satan can't come in. Dear God, thank you for your love and protection. Thank you for your word, the Bible.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.